In this video, we're going to talk about the future. We're going to talk about the future of IT services, the future of cloud computing, and the future of security. G'day, Dan. How are you?
Good, thanks, Tim.
So as someone who's been involved in IT, running an IT company for 20-something years, you must have seen some patterns emerge. What do you see coming when it comes to IT services?
Yeah, IT services used to be very manually intensive. We used to have to go and sit down in front of the computer or the server. It may have taken several hours to do a report and to go through and do all the checks that we need to do. Most of that is now largely automated with the tools that we can use. And not only that, it's real time as well. So if there's a problem that occurs on a server, we can have an alert that comes up and tells us that there's a problem there. Either have somebody connect in and fix it. In some cases, the software itself can automatically heal some of these faults that are starting to occur in the servers and in the desktops. So it's much more automated, enables the software to take care of the task rather than relying on a human to do it.
It sounds like the software is becoming more artificially intelligent.
It may be the case.
All right, let's look to the future when it comes to cloud computing. What are some of the trends that are emerging there?
Yeah, I mean, the cloud space has been moving quite rapidly in the last few years, certainly the last decade it's been moving, and we've seen large businesses, vast empires being built in the cloud environment. The thing to watch for me, there's quite a few areas, but the focus that we have is particularly around the Internet of Things. So that's using sensors and devices to be able to send data back into the cloud to enable businesses to make better decisions about what's going on with their equipment.
Let's talk about a third area, which is security. And in a positive fashion, let's talk about some of the trends that are emerging.
The security landscape changes quite rapidly. I mean, for us, it changes almost week by week, and we see new threats emerging. So some of the more scary things that we're starting to see is emails that are actually coming in to a user and saying, this is your username, and we also have your password. And the password is an accurate password.
How do they find that out?
So there's databases that have been out on the internet that have been hacked from time to time that may have legitimate information, username and passwords in them that are real usernames.
Right, you're talking
passwords.
About some of these big hacks that wind up with press attention, like I want to say some of the big shopping companies and so forth, I think, have been hacked one way or another over the last 10 years. So those databases are still around.
That's right. I mean, an example that comes to mind is the Adobe website. It was hacked about 2 to 3 years ago. So a lot of people use Adobe Reader or Adobe Acrobat. They may have put in a username and a password. That may be the same password that they use for their internet banking, for example.
Right.
So imagine, Tim, if you then got an email that said, hi, Tim, this is your username and this is your password. Now, that password is your Adobe password, but
right.
It may also be your internet banking
right.
password
and if
as
I
well.
Haven't changed it, I'm in all kinds of, I would think I'm in all kinds of trouble.
Absolutely.
What's a proactive approach to this, knowing that this threat is emerging?
So what we say to people is make sure that you're changing your passwords on a regular basis. So if you change your passwords 2 to 3 times a year, that's probably enough to keep just 1 or 2 steps ahead of the hackers who may have that password that you used in 2013.
All right, excellent. Any other big trends that we need to be aware of? Or that's 3 pretty good ones, I think, from 3 big slices of the industry.
Look, the takeout for the trends for me is just look for the different pieces out there which can enable your business to be able to grow and to be productive. It's different for everyone, but certainly have a look at what is relevant for you and see how you can put into practice.
All right, terrific, thank you. For those of you who'd like to find out more, you can go visit Dan through his book, Downtime, Disruption and Deception, which is available on Amazon, or approach him directly through his website or his team on sabervox.com.au.